So if you watched the previous video, then you'll know I already did the three stories, the three main, well, not main, but the three longer stories, I think, at least in terms of the amount of pages they occupy, including probably is the most famous and, in my opinion, probably the best story in the whole book about the six witnesses, different opinions on the nobleman, the noblewoman, and the bandit. But I'm going to be talking about the equally important and equally good other three stories in the book, which include yam soup. I'm not sure what it's called. It's a special kind of soup that's made with lamb. I mean yam, sorry, which is, for those of you who don't know, basically a sweet potato that you can take from the ground, and it tastes really good. I've tried it. And so for those of you who haven't watched the first video, I would recommend you do so without watching this video first, because you might find some things confusing. All right, so the story about the yam soup, I keep forgetting what's the specific name for it, so I'm just gonna call it yam soup. All right, so the yam soup, it's about the samurai who gets teased by everybody. He has a red nose, he looks sad. Well, he doesn't look sad, but he has an expressionless face all the time. He doesn't really respond to anybody teasing him about pretty much everything. Even the children tease him, which is sort of depressing for a samurai. And anyway, he loves this yam soup. So he gets to have some once a year, every time in when all of the samurais are invited to the king's massive dinner. And in one dinner, he eats his yam soup. He finds it delicious, even though he only has a tiny portion of it. But then a prince sees him, and so the prince asks, "Here, have some more." Even though technically he's not supposed to, he's like, "Who cares?" So he has more, and then prince invites him to go to his palace, and they ride for days and nights in completely tiring situations. And finally, they reach the prince's palace. He eats so much of this yam soup that he actually starts to find, "I'm not liking it that much, you know? I've had so much, I don't really like it that much now." And the moral of the story basically is, the more you have of something, the less valuable it is. Imagine if diamonds were sand. Well, you could just scoop armfuls of diamonds off the ground, and who would care about diamonds anymore? No one would even want one anymore, as pretty as they look still. All right, so the second story is about the martyr. Now, I'm not exactly sure I'm getting this pronounced correctly. The Martyr, Lorenzo the Martyr. And the story is about a boy who's adopted by the church. He's very nice, he's charming, he's handsome, he's good at his studies, and everybody loves him basically. Until when he's like around late teenagers, and then he refuses to admit that he got a local girl pregnant, and so he gets kicked out. After a while back, there's a fire, a massive fire that burns everything. And the baby that Lorenzo had, which we don't know whether it's true or not, is stuck in the house. And Lorenzo uses his life and saves the baby. But then there's a confession for the girl who accused Lorenzo of impregnating her and saying this is Lorenzo's baby. Well, she makes a confession. It actually wasn't Lorenzo's baby, it was somebody else's. And so Lorenzo's been falsely blamed the whole time. And in addition to that, Lorenzo, in the end, they find out is actually a girl. So, you know, the entire story is sort of confusing, but he's given the name Lorenzo the Martyr, which, for those of you who don't know what a martyr is, basically someone who sacrifices their life for their religion. Or because Lorenzo was like adopted by the church, but most of the time it's used towards Christianity. You don't really see other religions using that as much, or I haven't seen it at least. And so the third and the absolute final story of this entire series is about a man and a woman, well, two men and a woman, and the love competition. So basically, these two men both love the same woman. One man marries the woman, and the woman's happy with the man, right? But until the other man starts to find, after that man is married to her, he actually doesn't like her that much. And so he's like, "Yeah, whatever, hands off." He doesn't like, he actually is fine with the men. He doesn't hate the other guy as much as he thought he does. But the woman, the wife of the husband, actually asks him to kill her husband, and he does in the end. So this story, I'm not exactly sure what's the moral here, but it's a very interesting story, I have to say. And it's definitely tone changer. Okay, so over on this series, I have to say my favorite story would, the two favorites would be the yam soup, the yam soup, okay. I mistaken it with lamb, but the yam soup and the six witnesses. So, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this entire book review, and thanks for watching chapter one. Oh, I forgot to say, make sure to subscribe and place a like. Thank you. Every subscribe matters so much to me. And thanks for watching chapter one.